Hello, everybody. Going live with the Jansen trio back here. Here we go. Going live, Jansen trio. Gonna have as soon as I see some eyeballs on the screen, we're gonna do a little fun Friday. Up, oh, first eyeball. Hello, eyeball. Hello, eyeball. I don't know who they are yet, but there's somebody out there, kids. Like, oh, two eyeballs. We got two. Here we go. We are gonna have a fun Friday presentation for you. The Jansen trio back here and myself are going to perform live on air a queen dance party before we do our mobility stretch. Because you know, dancing is part of mobility. So let's get this rocking and rolling. Hold on, without further ado. Here we go. Queen, don't stop. Friday, don't stop me now. Okay, dance. Good time. Nothing says mobility like dancing. Come on, everybody. Don't stop me. Thank you, everybody, for our fun Friday. Welcome. Let's do a little mobility for a half hour, followed by a half hour of core. Hopefully that was entertaining for y'all. Jumping around, right? Welcome, everybody. Who do we got on the queue? Nice. Let's rock and roll. Here we go. Wait till mommy get the other music started. All right out of the gates. Bring that arm across. Stretch that tricep out. About 5 or so seconds, we're gonna switch sides. Stretch that guy across. Bring the elbow up above. Taking that guy behind our head, big reach. Followed by the other side, switching it up, big reach, get that thing to reach across. All queued up now, a little dance party. Hands on your hips, we're gonna do a big hula hoop. Swinging that thing around, bottom back, hips forward, reaching through, big circles. Get the hips going in one direction. Really feel your hamstrings and glutes as I come back. Boy, I get that nice little hamstring and glute stretch as I race around. Switching sides or directions. Turning that around. There we go. Step over the hedge, looks like this. Open up those hips. Step it back. So both feet should be pointed towards you. Stepping up. Stepping back. Big open, big reach. Your hip is just like your shoulder in a sense of all these muscles back here are externally opening up and rotating that femur. It's just like your rotator cuff. Very important to stay loose and malleable. Mobility is the key to life. Hold here, open up the other side. Big reach. Big reach. Nice job, we're opening up. My partner over here is drawing me signs. Right, Annie? Oh, she's got an exercise that she wants us all to do. You want to see my sign? Dad. All right, now we're going to do a little side reach. Hand's going to come up. We're going to reach down with that hand. Big open up. How far can we bend to get the ribs away from the hips? Reaching down. Get that elbow up towards the sky. Really reach. Take a huge inhale. Let it all the way out. Bigger reach. And switch sides. I feel good. Open up. Big reach. Get that elbow up as high as you can get it. Ribs are pulling away. Hands are gonna be out front. We're going to rotate. Just stay in big circles for me right now, but we're gonna get going with a little bit of low to high in a second. Keep your hips square. Your hips should be facing me like my hips are facing you. So don't turn. Keep those hips square and just rotate side to side. How much range of motion can you gain? Let all those little erector spinae muscles along your spine loosen up. Big reach. Now we're gonna go from low to high. So it's here and there. She can come play if she wants. Low to high.
She wanted to make a program.
Low to high. I know. She can give us one exercise to do.
Oh, she
did. Big reach. Now we're gonna switch sides. Come over here, no crying. There's no crying in baseball.
She wanted to demonstrate.
Come over here. You want to come sit over here?
I think Daddy meant for you to do
big reach.
You can do one. You want to do one?
There we go. Nice job. My little kindergartner is going to give us an exercise. She's coming out. Maddie Grace. What's she doing? Come over a little bit so we can see you. Come over there. There she is. Here we go. Oh, she's got a little splits there with the leg open for us. Let's see if I can match her. I'll go behind. She's got the left leg over with the right leg extended. So point those toes. She's reaching back. Look, oh, straighten it out. She told me, straighten it out. Get those legs to go apart. Actually feels really good on my hip flexors. And I'm getting a nice side bend here. Ready to switch sides? Scissor switch. Nice. Reach out. Reach your leg away from you. Lock that leg out, like Maddie said, our coach Maddie. All right, big helper. She got her programming in. Here we go. Feet are going to be super wide. We're going to lean from side to side. So here, just like I always say, make sure your bottom's going backwards so we're splitting the difference. Try to keep your knees behind your toes. Looks like this if I'm sideways to you. Bottom's back, knees behind my toe. Big reach, side to side. Keep that flow going. Big reach. There we go. One more side. Nice. Everybody doing okay? We're gonna go reach out our shins or our toes here soon. Hi, Danielle. How's Virginia? Reach out. Reach out. Get those feet out or your shins. Reach out as far as you can. Fire those legs up. Who can be a rocket? I didn't see John watching, but I know John can kick up. Show me those kicks, John. Keep that going for me. I'm gonna get a drink of water. Nice job, Colin. Remember to hydrate. Okay, ready to rock and roll? Hands are gonna be behind. We're gonna reach back, lock that out. Pulling through, that's gonna get the... Here we go, big reach. I'm gonna hold this for 5 more seconds. I'm gonna come out of it and then go back into it. When you're in there, you can kind of do a little twisting. Feel that lower back, come back out. Nice deep stretch, do it again. Here we go. Hands come away, keep those elbows completely locked out. That stretches that bicep tendon. Reaching through. Job, everyone. Nice job. Followed by big arm circles. Get that circle through. Big reach. Show me what you got. Anybody want to see anything special? Another dance party? Let me know. Switching sides. Big stretch. Get those shoulders going. Now we're going back to the right side, but going backwards this time. Open up like you're doing a nice backstroke in a pool. Those days when we used to be able to swim with our friends in pools. Switch sides. Nice work. I know everybody here doesn't follow my social media stuff, but I found the world's best meme that my wife sent me, so I posted it. It said, imagine a place where you have Taco Tuesday and Cinco de Mayo happening on the same day, but you can't celebrate because of a Mexican named beer. Big reach each time. Nice job. Loosen those shoulders up. We're gonna do some neck circles here in a second. Everybody's doing good, looks like. Big circles around. Get those circles going with the neck. All the way around. Who's got a nice long neck like me, like a giraffe? Loosen that guy up all the way around. Making sure you're rotating both sides. Nice job. Followed by our ankles, same thing. Gonna get those guys rotating, so it's a big turn. Rotate through that joint. Get the toes to come down. Rotate through. I'm leaning. Rotate through, switch directions. Get that guy to rotate around. And switch sides. Turn on those toes. Rotate that ankle joint open. Switch directions. This is not the sexiest programming, but essential. Nice job. It's a good thing you pedicures either, so don't worry about my toes and my feet. Everybody doing all right? Here we go. We're gonna have a little knee stretch. Knee's gonna come up. Rotate through. Get that hip to turn for us. Turn those hips open. Big reach. Big arch. One more time each side. There we go. Now we're going to reach down and grab our toes, and then try and get your elbows to go between your knees, so it looks like this. If you're not as flexible, just grab your shins. But looks like this, sinking down in between. So get down in that little position there. Once I'm there, I'm going to pull back out while holding on to my toes, lock out those hamstrings. So it looks like this from the side, tuck down in, Do your best, get as low as you can. Pull those hamstrings out, make sure it's nice and elongated through there. Sink back down in. Lock those legs out. Sink back through. Nice job, lock them out. Little twist at the top. Last one. There we go. We'll do a standing quadricep stretch, and then we're gonna go to the floor and do our full hip flexor stretch. So I'll check your balance. If you need to, grab a couch, grab a chair, grab a wall. Leg comes back. We're gonna hold that guy. Now it's gonna have that quadricep come over that knee joint, and then I'm gonna bend down into it. So bend down into it, hold. Pick a spot 3 or 4 feet out in front of you so you can find your little focal point. See if you can hold that guy. Nice job. Don't worry about it if you're wobbling, just reset, find your spot. Let your brain sink into it. Good, switching sides. Pick that focus point out in front for me. There we go. Perfect, just like Karate Kid with my crane pose. If anybody's paying attention. Anybody else out there? Okay, here we go. Let's hit the ground. I'm gonna grab my mat. So if you got one, hold out. I was lucky enough to have Daddy Love You signs on top of my. Here we go, pulling that mat out. Go back into that kneeling hip flexor stretch like I promised. So we're gonna stay in this position. Make sure that foot is out in front of my knee. So hopefully you can see that pretty well. I'm gonna have my hands on my hip. I have a big natural arch back there, so I'm not gonna be arching that thing through. I'm gonna hold this tight, keep this in as I press through. So once I'm in that position, I'm just gonna kind of sink through it. Breathe, take a few deep breaths. Sitting through that guy. Now once I'm into that pretty good, I'm gonna pull out. Take that front side hand, pull it open. That's gonna engage the iliopsoas a little bit. So now I'm getting the hip flexor down the right leg, iliopsoas coming from my spine. And I'm gonna turn my focus this way. So turning away from you slightly, hips are now orientated that direction instead of this way. And I'm pushing through using that knee as an anchor. Pull through, take some deep breaths. Really sink through those hip flexors. Oh, it's gorgeous. It's Friday. There we go. Switching sides. So now I'm going to take that front hand, pull it out like an anchor, and then I'm going to be pointing towards you. So instead of going that direction, I'm actually turning my pelvis that way, pressing up. That way, not only do I get my hip flexors to fire, but right along my spine, those last 5 vertebra that has a little transverse abdominis, the little transverse process, this little guy, it coming all the way out, attaching to my femur. So those guys is where the iliopsoas lives. Iliacus along the hip, psoas major on the front side. It's the soccer player muscle when they kick the ball across their body. Pulling out. There we go. It's gonna get us down on the ground for some dead bugs, work coordination for our brain. Remember, it's important to get that cross crawl methodology so my right side's gonna make my left side work. That's where that dead bug comes into play just perfect. So let's see if I can angle this direction. Here we go, all the way flat on my back. Gonna turn that guy. So once those feet come up in the air, my hands are gonna be up as well. So what I want to do is drop away my right hand and my left foot. So once my head is back and relaxed, slamming that lower back into the ground. Make sure you got pressure, right? I shouldn't be able to feel underneath there. So I'm going to take my left leg away and my right hand. There we go. Right back up. Opposite foot, opposite hand. And back up. Keep that going. This doesn't happen when we're eye guzzling Netflix. There we go. One more each side. Nice job. Now we're going to go up into some bridges. So hopefully I can turn a little bit for you. There we go. So driving my heels into the ground, you're going to see me lift up those glutes. So hands are going to be at my side. If you want to make it a little more challenging, just raise your hands. But it's going to be here. Squeeze those glutes nice and hard. Keep yourself up as high as you can. And down slow. Drive up. And down slow. Fire those glutes, keep them up. Squeeze those glutes there, good. And down slow. Drive it nice and high. Notice my toes are up off the ground, my heels are driving through. That activates that glute a little bit more. Second my toes come down, my quads activate, so get that glute to fire. One more. There we go. We're going to come up and do a little seated butterfly. There we go. Feet are going to be together. I'm going to drive those legs down with my elbows. See what kind of position you can be in. Be a nice tall for me. Pushing down. Get those legs to fall down towards the floor. Get those guys to go as flat as possible. Just like a butterfly, right, man? Driving down. There we go. Now that we're in there, one foot's going to come forward, other leg's going to come over the top. We're going to use this as a leverage angle again to be able to turn and twist, get that lumbar spine going from a nice seated position. Drive my elbow or my hand based on your flexibility, turning and rotating away from me. Big reach. Really turning and rotating, using that elbow for leverage. And switch sides. So once I get there, cross that leg up and over. Elbow again, or hand is going to be pulling. Getting the knee to go that direction while my body goes the opposite way. Big rotate through. Boy, that feels good on that lower back. Get a quick little drink of water here. Give you guys a breather. Then we're going to come back to the ground for our dynamic version of that lower back stretch where we bring that leg up and from one side to the other, trying to keep the shoulders down. So give us a little 10-second breather here. I'm going to line myself up to where I can kick those legs out when I come back. Oh, thank you. Apparently I got lemonade. Hopefully low on the sugar. Stevia lemonade, that's even better. And this little water here, I got a little Himalayan salt. Keep my... Try Natty's little Stevia lemonade. Anybody want a sip? Ooh, nice and lemony, tart. Hi, Lisa. Hi, Paige. That was delicious, thank you, Natty. Big smile. All right, let's see where I'm at here. Okay, a couple more minutes. Remember, as promised, we're gonna be lying flat on the back, bringing that leg all the way over to the other side, keep those shoulders down. So it looks like this. Trying to orientate myself where you can see me well. But once I'm down, that leg's gonna come up, just whatever your flexibility can handle. Both shoulders are trying to stay down. That's why you take those hands out to your side. Bring that leg all the way across, and then all the way open. Feel that adductor, get a big stretch on the inside. Slide away so I don't hit my couch. All the way up and all the way over. Let's keep that flow going. Each time, trying to increase that by a little bit more. Reach across your body. Get that thing kicking open. Nice job. I'm gonna Across that body, big stretch. Get that lumbar spine open all the way up. Last one. Get that adductor to go. Good job. Switching sides. Making sure you got enough room, right? Open that thing up. Woo, there goes that adductor. And then switching sides. Get that lower back involved. See that shoulder start to come up? Don't let it. Really reach across. That's better, Mr. Jansen. Good job. Open it up. Get that shoulder down. Woo. There we go. One more. In a squatted position. Feet will be nice and wide. As I bend down in that squat, I'm going to use that arm. So bend down into it. Lock that elbow out and then reach across. Really locking out that adductor. Ooh, yeah. Switching sides. So as I squat down, use that elbow against that knee. Open myself up. All the way up. One more on each side. Squat into it. You can see I'm more mobile on my right side. I can get all the way down. There we go. This is my old ACL knee. I can get reasonably close, but not the same. Woo, a little tight. There we go, big reach. Nice job. All right, all we have left is the one I get free beers on airlines when I fly, when I used to fly anyway. Go to the back, tell them, hey, I got a great stretch for you guys. Looks like this. Cross one leg over the other, sit back into that. Get that nice piriformis loose. Get rid of the lower back stretch. You know, 7 out of 10 times you show this to a flight attendant, next thing you know, you get a free IPA later. Just a trainer tip. Sit back. If I can do it, there we go. Loosen up that glute. See if I can do it without balancing, there we go. Nice job. We're gonna be transitioning to our core section, so if you wanna stay with us, I would love that. If you wanna jump off and then restart, or if someone's just joining us, that'd be super fun. So hopefully everyone's having a lovely Friday. Let's check in, see what everyone's doing. Here comes the abtastic. Let's get those cores going. All right, little music change. Everybody ready? Turn this thing up a little bit. Right? Okay, steam engines, hands above. As I drop into a squat, I'm gonna come up and bam! Touch that elbow to the knee. Nice. Big reach. Squat, steam engine. Squat, steam engine. 5 more seconds. Nice. My dancer was. Last one. Good job. Maddie's rocking out of here next time. Okay. Getting my app set up. So we get those 30-second intervals rocking. First, I have to take off my son's video games, right? This is quality television. YouTube tids gone. Here we go. All right, everybody. Let's do a little side bend. All right, feet will be wide. Hands gonna reach down. Big reach. This time we crank over. Get that oblique to fire. Reach. Crank back over. If you got a weight, put that in the down hand. Nice big heavy weight. All my clients know at the gym, my favorite exercise they get every time they come with me is this big old side bend with that oblique firing right there. That's what makes us athletes, is those obliques. It helps us rotate and side bend. 2 more. Good, switching sides. This hand comes up, this one reaches down, then we're gonna crank through. Fire that oblique. job. Gonna get 10 of these. There we are. Halfway there. Nice. Last one. Good job. Going down to the planks. Get ready. We're gonna do a plank for 30 seconds with some little taps. If you want to, instead of tapping, which is a little bit simpler of a progression, you can reach out with those hands. It's a little bit more challenging. Those are like those little punches, right? So here we go. On your elbows or on your hands, up to you. I'm gonna go up to my hands, starting now. Either get those taps going, or like I said, get those hands out. Press them through. Halfway there. Five seconds. Flip it over for us. There we go. Gonna go up into a little crab. Just like we did before, when I'm in that lying crab position, as I drive up each time, I'm gonna reach and tap. So we're gonna come back down. So it's up, reach and tap. Down, up, reach and tap. So the progression on this guy, if I wanna make it a little bit more challenging, is a full crab, up, reach. Come up, reach. So I'm gonna do that one, ready? 30 seconds, here we go. And go, up, reach. Up, reach. I got the added benefit of a slippery mat on a hardwood floor. Reaching up, turn. Nice job, halfway there. Reach. Reach, get those glutes to fire. Drive through your heels. Nice job, 5 seconds. 2 seconds. And done. You stay on the ground. I'm gonna check in on you guys. See how everybody's doing. Here we go. Let's rock this thing up a little bit. You're on a side plank. You're on a 30 second side plank, which means 15 seconds on each side. I'm gonna show you a couple options. My feet are gonna be both driving straight to the ground. Hopefully you can see those behind the couch there. I'm gonna elevate up and either do this or stay elevated, fire that guy, and I'm gonna do this. So you pick your level, starting now. Hip to be square, but it works. Good job, 5 seconds. And switching sides. Take my clock so I don't get lost. Up, good. 15 seconds, power through it. Keep that clearance off the ground. Nice job. There it is. Great job, everybody. All right, we're gonna do a little verstegen. So I'm gonna pull this mat up out of the way. These guys, I'm gonna walk out to you. Once I get out there, I'm gonna do a little knee drives. So it's like an inchworm. Coming out like this, walking all the way down. Once I get out there, drive, drive, and back. That's the whole movement, ready? 30 seconds, it's a long 30. Here we go, walking out. Once I'm there, drive, drive, and walk back out. All the way out, drive, drive. Should be able to get at least 5 of these in. Walking out. Drive through. Last one. All the way out. Drive through. Nice job. Powering out. There we go. We'll wake us up a little bit. Okay. If I was in the Olympics and I was going to throw a hammer, it looks like this. Turn it. Get that little deck. Here we go, starting right now. 15 seconds. Down, up. Remember the speed in which you crimp through this. You can kick your heart rate up, make it a little more challenging, but get that rotation through your foot. Rotate. It's hip to be square. Oh, I got pictures coming up here now. Switching sides. Drive down through that foot. Turn, ready, go. Great job, everybody. 5 seconds. And done. Woo! Little drink of water. I'm gonna show you my signs. Sign number one, Maddie.
She might go backwards with the flex.
What?
Just go backwards so the shirt can run.
There we go. Little drink of water, ready? Here we go, we're gonna do little bird dogs, but instead of the classic bird dog, we're gonna get up on get the knees off the ground, so be on the toes the whole time. So here's your classic, right? Classic bird dog is that guy. So you can progress down to him if you like. Otherwise, pop up, get those knees up off the ground. You can do this as you reach back like this, watch. So that's a good progression, or we can do this. 30 straight seconds. Nice job, there's 10. Keep up on those bears. Nice job, 10 seconds left. Reach it out. 5 seconds. Last one. Woo, felt good. Grabbing that mat. Now we're gonna go down to those little penguins. Everybody good? All right. So once I'm in that bottom position, it's gonna be here. As I come into the top of my crunch, I'm gonna reach out. So those legs are up. As I come up, I'm gonna reach, come back down. Up, reach. Come back down. So that way you're getting lots of movement out of that rectus abdominis or our six pack. Here we go. 30 seconds. So drive up, down, up, down. Get that full range of motion. Nice job, halfway there. Reach out those hands behind. Those guys are gonna lock in place. That's gonna let us be there. If you wanna add a little extras to it, put your hands behind your head. But we're gonna do this. As I elevate, I'm gonna slowly fall and then drive that guy back up again. Slow fall. Ready? So either way, this way or that way. 30 seconds starting right now. Up, down slow, drive it through. I call these the wave. Woo! It's like a sporting event. Use that momentum, ride the wave all the way up to some nice rectus abdominis. Whew, I feel that. My arms are a little sore from Tuesday. Good job. 5 seconds. And done. We're gonna roll over. I'm gonna face this direction. Come up into a nice cobra stretch. So once I'm down there, drive that belly button into the ground. Open yourself up. So you can actually push through with those elbows if you want. Stretch back out that rectus abdominis. Make sure it's not overly contracted. Nice job, 5 more seconds. Pressing a little higher for me. Stretching this guy out. And done. We go back into our side plank. So feet are gonna be here, driving my feet into the ground, all the way up, and then down. So each time I'm getting that big reach. Ready, 15 seconds, up, up. Driving up, 5 seconds. There it is, switching sides. Halfway there. And done. Good job. I'm going to go into an elbow plank. While I'm in that elbow plank, I'm going to get that rotation. So you're going to see my hips turn from one side to the other. Cranking that guy through. 30 second plank. Once I'm here, you're going to see turn. Turn. Try not to turn those feet, you're just turning your hips. 30 seconds. Driving that iliac crest to the ground, your hip bones. Anybody else find some metals underneath your couch? And done. I had no idea that I won my medal. It's too small. All right. Hands to turn. You can do a big wind with those hands coming out. You can bend them. You can just stay on your hips. Five more seconds this direction, we'll switch. And switch. Coming down. Driving with that elbow out. Nice work. Cranking through. One more second. And done. Good work. Quick little drink of the water here. I'll try the lemonade, since I used to be a bartender way back in my college days. I'm gonna mix them. Take my lemonade my daughter made with the fresh squeezed lemon and some stevia. Add in that Himalayan salt and water. Woo, thirsty. Everybody doing good? Yeah, no action, no comments. Everyone's probably working hard, out of breath. And that core to fire. All right, we're gonna do our V-tucks. Start in that seated position in a V. Grab your legs and you're gonna open up. So for 30 seconds, we're gonna play around this a little bit. Give you some options. Start here, be nice and tall. Pressing out. Good. All the way out. Go. Ten seconds. Let's stick the landing. Like Carrie Shrug with a single leg. Nice job. And done. I'm entertaining myself. I feel all alone. Anybody else out there? Here we go. Pointing this foot away from me, this hand's behind as I come into it. So this guy stays at 90. 30 straight seconds, starting. Now, reach, back out. Point that toe. Good job. 30 seconds each side. 1 minute of rotational crunches. Make sure you're coming down every time. Drive that shoulder up off the ground. Nice job. And switch sides. Point that foot. This kind of stays up elevated. Opposite knee comes across. Ready? Go. See if I get this right. Too many things at once. My brain misfired. Don't look at the clock. Nice job. Reach. Roam around the world. Except for when there's COVID-19. Drive through. Calm that bad boy out. Yeah. Here we go. A little stretchy. Open that guy up. Belly button's going to ground. I'm stretching up away from it. There we go. All right, got a little Russian twist for y'all. This time I'm gonna use my towel. Bring that towel in. So this time I'm gonna slap every time to the ground. As if I had a weight. If you've got a weight, use it. If you wanna use a weight, get after it. Looks like this though. Oh good, I got a sticker. It's an E. Oh, she spelled I love dogs. Here we go, we're gonna stay up in that Russian twist and we're gonna snap that bad boy from side to side. I won't make that noise, don't worry. A little too violent for Friday. All the way up, although it is May Day. Here we go, 30 seconds. Russian twist. This is the upgrade. If you need to, drop those heels down and rotate. Reaching across. Halfway there. Bring it up a notch. Great work. Five seconds. And done. Good job, everybody. That fan really helps. Not so strong. 20 seconds, here we go. All the way flat. Legs are up in the air. This is the one where if you need to, get a little momentum, come down, and then rock him back up. So it looks like this. If you need to, get that elevation up when that guy cranks through. Otherwise, hands down below, just driving out. Up, down soft. 20 seconds. Starting right. Now, up. Get those glutes up off the ground. Down slow. Fight gravity. Nice job. Just hopefully like you're fighting going to the pantry and the refrigerator. Keep moving. Stay strong. Get those glutes up off the ground. 4 seconds. Nice job. Woo! Helm those guys out. I'm gonna go back into a plank. This time in our plank, we're going to do a little twist. So the knee is going to come through and twist as it rotates in. So it looks like this. Once I'm in that plank, she's going to join me. Once I'm in that plank, I'm going to rotate through, twist, and then twist. Okay? 20 seconds. Starting right now. Up. Rotate. Rotate. Stay in that plank. Turn those knees to elbows. Get a twist in there. My lips are sealed. Stay with your both feet on the ground. And then rotate. Watch. Both feet. Turn. Both feet. Turn. Only one foot comes off the ground. Next one. Taking my magic E off. E for exercise. Over there for me. All right, we're gonna go back into what we started with, those little twisters. Bring that guy in, rotate up. Cranking those guys through. 20 seconds. Get that standing rotation, opposite knee to opposite elbow. There we go, cranking through. job. It's a good little cover. Little 80s song cover. Whoa, that's very flexible. Everybody doing good? All right, I got one more for you. She wants to still keep going, have some fun. So I'm gonna put my feet out in front. I'm gonna lay supine, so back on your back again. This time I'm gonna kick those legs out like a V. We'll do a couple options. Maybe I'll lift a Maddie. We'll see how that works. But we'll be here. Feet will be wide, so hopefully you can see my feet are out in that beautiful V there. All the way flat. Reason why you need that V is because you need to pop out. So heels are coming down. If I have a heavy object, take that with you and drive it up and out. Down slow, drive it up and out. Use that power, drive through those heels. Drive it up, big power. Reach all the way to the top. Normally we do these with sandbags. Pressing through. Last one. Good job, everyone. A little stretchy. All right, we're gonna finish off with another little stretch for us. First, let's try that hip flexor again, because remember, our core is not just what we can see in our abs. It actually connects our legs to our rib cage, all the way through that spine. So this guy here is that little hip flexor stretch. If you're with us for the first half hour, we're gonna push through, open up that hip flexor. Because I wanna keep you mobile and moving, I'm gonna bounce in and out of it, keeping this guy very dynamic, so it's not so long of a hold for a static stretch. But we're gonna be pressing through that guy. And switch sides. One of the biggest mistakes I always hear from clients is they do a bunch of core, and then they do that at the end of their workout, and then they hit the showers or they hit home, and they never stretch their soles back out here. And then later on they can get cramping, or they can really feel a lot of knee or hip pain because the anterior portions of that stuff is all super loaded. Happens to a lot of guys at the gym doing those weighted crunches. So you really want to loosen these guys up. That's why you go into those little cobra stretches like this. Press away. Take some deep breaths. Let your pelvis stay low. Nice job. I'm going to transition into a little stretch as we come across. So this guy's going to come through here and then all the way over. So the goal here is to keep your body down and reach across. These are called scorpions. And that's going to loosen up that lumbar spine. So reaching across. Good job, Eddie. Last one we're going to do again is that rotation. So we'll be here. One leg's there. We're going to turn and rotate. Quickly switch sides, turn and rotate. We'll do this two times. Good, switch your sides again. And last one. There we go. Last but not least, I'm gonna open that up. Feet will be out wide. I'm gonna turn and open up this way. Deep breath. Mommy, serve your lunch. Open up and rotate. Thank you everyone for joining us. Maddie wants me to do one stretch for her. Come over here and demo. Come over here, she's gonna demo for us.
Lay down and put your legs straight.
Lay down and put the legs straight, she says. Point your toe, point that left toe, point this toe. Good job. Switching sides. That's right. Stretches the back of your calf, your hamstring. Last stretch was by Maddie. Good job. All right, everyone. Thank you very much. Hope you enjoyed it. It's a beautiful Friday. Get outside. Get some sunshine going. Bye-bye from Holland and Maddie. Will you guys turn that speaker down? Do you guys want to exit on another little dance party? Turn that guy off. There we go.
Ready?
See if I can pull back up my queen again. There they are, the Jansons. As I'm trying to find it, sorry.
Hi, girls.
It's lunchtime.
Lunchtime.
This is taking me a little while, isn't it? Should have had this on demand. Don't stop me now.
Don't stop me now. Don't stop me now.
Oh, well, there we go. Now just dance. Call him Mr. Fahrenheit. Happy Friday. Bye, everybody. Mad love.